Yeah, so lead bullets versus silver bullets is another really deep idea. Sounds simple. It isn't that simple. It comes from Ben Horowitz, who's written an amazing, well, a lot of amazing things in the entrepreneurial space. Obviously, one of the founders of a16z, one of the top venture capitalists in the world, and he wrote this book called The Hard Thing About Hard Things. And one of the things he highlights in there is lead bullets versus silver bullets. And he also wrote a blog post about it beforehand. And his thing is like a silver bullet is like a magical solution that's going to solve all your biggest and worst problems in your business. So, your business isn't going the way it's supposed to go, and that's the default situation as a founder. And then there's this temptation to say, well, if we just get X, then everything will be okay. That's the silver bullet that's going to kill the monster, right? So you've got all these business problems, and if we just get the product here, or if we just close that big customer, or if we just so when you think if you think if we just do magical thing whatever, all our problems will be solved, that's silver bullets. And silver bullets don't work. They're very tempting, and it's kind of this emotional thing of like, I'm so sick and tired of the uncertainty and the hard work and everything just breaking. I'm so exhausted by all of this as a founder. I just want a solution. And that's where the desire for the silver bullet comes from. So then you say, well, if I just close this customer, or I just make this change to the product or whatever, all my problems will go away. But actually, all your problems will never go away. Even if you Elon Musk or Jeff Bezos, life is this continuous series of problems which you have to respond creatively to. So there is no silver bullet. There is no magical solution. And Ben's answer is they're only lead bullets. So there's only consistently and constantly identifying problems, embracing those problems, solving those problems creatively. And when you solve those problems, it just creates a whole nother layer of problems as your business grows. So if you solve that HR problem, your business will grow and you'll have even worse HR problems. You solve that technology problem, your platform will get more usage, your technology problems will get even worse. You solve that customer problem, your business grows tenfold. Now you've got even worse customer problems. So, there's no Ben's point, and he's a very experienced entrepreneur and VC, is like, there's never a solution to problems. Problems create more problems. Hopefully, you have fun along the way. Hopefully, you make money along the way. Hopefully, you build amazing connections with people. But as a human being building a business, there is no end to problems. So embrace that. It's never going to be over. There are no silver bullets. There is no magic. There's just having fun with finding problems, fixing problems, and growing your business. And that's lead bullets all the way. And my own personal experience of this is I'm like kind of a silver bullet person by nature. So I'm like, I was always like trying to find clever solutions and shortcuts and whatever. And in constrained environments, like say high school or university, that actually works fine. You can find the sort of way to unlock getting through your course with less studying or getting an A for a project or whatever, because it's quite a constrained environment that you're operating in. It's sort of a manufactured reality that other people have created for you. And in that situation, silver bullets actually work. And so you get kind of misled by the education system to think that silver bullets are a good thing and you should try and find them and use them. So I was sort of in that mindset when I started my business. But when you're building a business, it's not a manufactured or protected environment. No one's making it for you. It's the real world. There's no teacher or university professor or boss or whatever protecting you from reality. And reality is open-ended, it's infinite. So the problems never end. And so you've got to get into this mindset of just enjoying taking the punches and dealing with them creatively and moving on to the next problem. And that's just lead bullets. It's lead bullets all the way down, to horribly mix the metaphors. So that's lead bullets versus silver bullets. And that's been the most important, one of the most important lessons for me. And you can see it in Matt Mosher's teachings as well. He talks about the importance of inbox zero. And you're like, inbox zero, that is so trivial. Who the fuck cares if you've got zero emails in your inbox? There's so many more important problems to deal with. But again, the philosophy is lead bullets. Like if you're not taking care of all of those details, if you haven't answered and responded to every single email, if you don't have a neat getting things done system, if you're not systematically identifying issues and dealing with them, all of those things add up to a great business. So like there's no like the temptation is to say, oh, forget my inbox. When I just close this deal, everything will be solved. No, it won't. You'll still have a messy inbox and you won't know what's going on with your customers and your team will be upset that you haven't responded to them. So there are no magical solutions. It's just kind of hard work all the way down and problems, and you might as well have fun and embrace it and accept it. That's lead bullets.